Welcome to the Howe Bulldogs Coaches Show with Zack Hudson, brought to you by FBC Howe. Now, let's go to Monty Walker with the Bulldogs head coach.
All right, Coach, at least we'll start out talking about what's been going on in South Texas this week, Hurricane Harvey. And I know you've got some family down there. Have you been in touch, and what's the situation?
We have. We lived down there for 12 years, and coached down there the whole time. And so it's a pretty sad moment, but a town I coached in, LaGrange, of course, got hit just about the hardest because the Colorado River goes through there. Guy I coached with lost his house. It's under 7 feet of water. I've seen some bad flooding down there, but never like that. But as far as our family goes, everybody's still good. Our hometown got 28 inches of rain. Coach Barber, who coached here 4 years ago, is in Conroe. They can't leave their house, but they're not wet. They're still driving. Everybody within a mile of them, outside of a mile of them, had to evacuate. They just happened to be on the higher ground. So it's a scary situation for a lot of people. And, it's one of those things where you wouldn't wish that on anybody.
So let's talk about the difference. Let's go into football now. Let's talk about the difference between the wing tee and the slot tee that you ran from last year.
Well, there's a lot of small differences, when you talk about blocking schemes and things of that nature. But when you look at the big picture, the wing tee has a receiver, and the slot tee doesn't. There you go. If you want to really look at the nitty-gritty. Now, we've done some things due to our quarterback and due to the kids we have. We've done some things to try to help them, but we're not changing the offense. Sometimes you can get under center. Sometimes you can get in a pistol, which is 3.5 behind the center. Things like that really don't change the offense. It changes where the quarterback, and it just helps the quarterback sometimes. So we've done some different things like that. But there's not a massive difference between the two. You can draw up. I would say 95% of the plays we had in slot T, we run the same exact plays. It's just you have to block it a little different because you're removing it. With the receiver, but at the same time, you also have the option to throw it a little easier. And you also, if you can throw it well enough, you can get more people out of the box, and that's where it helps.
Well, let's talk about the quarterback who's going to be running that. Freshman Kirby Cohealy, a move in. What have you seen from him so far?
Well, number one, he's a great kid. He's a coach's kid, so he understands the gig. He understands there's some pressure on him. We expect him to perform. The good part about coaches' kids is they're used to it. They're used to seeing the bright lights and all that. So I don't think that'll be a big issue with him. But we're also taking care of him. We're not going to, go through five progression reads or anything like that. We make it simple where he's got one reader. He's going to throw it on the track and go the next down. So just different things like that. But we'll take care of him. But it's a little easier to take care of him with Andrew Griffin and Moreau and Riggs and all of them behind him, carry the rock, and that makes it a little easier to take care of the quarterback.
Well, let's talk about your kicker. You had a great one move out, and Bryce Honaker had to replace the kicker, and found an interesting kicker to take his place.
Yeah, Coach Fry is one of our coaches, and he had an experience 1 year when he was the head coach in ARF that he had a girl come out and kick and was one of his best kickers. And that's all she does. That's all she did for him. And Callie was actually our water girl, and she plays select soccer. So he asked her to come out to practice one day and threw a ball out there, and took her about four chances, and then she started making 5 out of 6 at every spot we put it at. And in high school football, that's pretty good. And so we suited her up against Aubrey. She kicked an extra point there with no problems. Timing was actually better than I've seen our timing be in probably 4 or 5 years. So, I don't see a problem with any of it. But that's all she does. She'll just do our extra points and our field goals. She won't do our kickoffs or anything like that. But she's excited. Her parents are excited. Whatever it takes.
Opening night here against Gunter. The field looks spectacular, as it always does since you've been here. Talk about the hours and how much time it takes to put into this thing.
I don't know. It's a lot. And our coaches, it's all of us. I'll come out here and mow, and Coach Ellington comes out here and sweeps it. Different coaches come out here and mow at different times just to keep it mowed. And you know, had a little struggle right now with the greenness because it was hard to get on it. It was so wet in the last couple of weeks. And so, you know, it almost looks like we're scalping it now. But it'll be greened up by Friday. It'll all look good. But it takes a lot of hours by a lot of people. You know, our maintenance department helps us and everybody. But all our fields are done by our coaches. So it takes a lot of hours. Our kids enjoy it. I think the community enjoys it. You know, it's nice to show up and have a beautiful field to play on. And people come here, they know they're going to see top-notch facilities.
Gunter Tigers opening the season with the defending champs from a year ago, state champions. Are they different from a year ago? They lost some key players, some talent, but are you going to see a step down or a step up? How do they look?
I think they've kept the ball rolling, you know. Be honest, I think they've. I think every week they got better running that new offense they were running. I think last year when we caught them, you know, they were still kind of in the early stages of it. The more I watched them, I saw them play Pottsboro as far as the film. I went to the state championship game, so I saw them a couple times throughout the season, and so you could just see them progressively getting better. And of course, that culminated to the state championship. But you know, you look at it, you can see them understanding it more and things like that. But defensively, they, you know, they're returning eight. And the guys they're having to replace with are pretty good. So it is going to be a game, and I look forward to it. I like playing good people. I don't like schedules where you just walk out there and beat people. And we're going to have to play in Gunter Noser. You know, last year we got into a little issue with, you know, two bad turnovers at the wrong time on the 5-yard line. You know, sometimes it ain't your night, but, you know, 2 years ago it was our night. So we know we're going to have to play. They know they're going to have to play. But, you know, the kids all know each other. It kind of gets a little scrappy every once in a while. It's what it's about. You know, hometowns come together, get a little scrappy, and after it's over, we'll all shake hands, be friends again. So it'll be fun.
What do you think the keys are to getting a victory here?
We're gonna have to control the ball on offense. Keep their offense off the field. And, you know, our kids are used to that. That's what we do. That's the name of our game. They play like we play. And so we have to make sure we stay with what we do and not catch or anything else. We have to attack just like they do and just like we do. So, you know, we just got to make sure we don't let them catch us off guard with something. Get a big play, make them earn everything. You know, good football teams, you know, they're going to look at us the same way. You have to make them earn everything. And when they make a mistake, you have to capitalize. And we'll see where we are. But I feel very confident in our offense. I feel very confident in our defense. Our coaches have done a great job. Our kids are excited. We've probably had the best 3 days of practice we've had all year. Of course, it was only 3 days consecutive that we've had in practice, but just due to the rain. But it's an exciting time. And
well, don't forget, you can catch the game live on HoweEnterprise.com tonight. Kickoff pregame show starts at 7 p.m. If you're inside the stadium, you can pick it up on 99.9 FM. So bring your headphones to the game. For Coach Hudson, I'm Monty Walker. We'll see you next week.